On this video, we do the following five composite functions. This is part 7 of functions, and we're going to be doing some more examples with composite functions. Remember the definition, the notation? If I write the parentheses, f of g of x, remember this little circle here means that's a composite function. That just means f of g of x. So let's try some examples. Let's say we've got these three functions, f of x equals x squared minus 3x plus 5, g of x equals negative 4x plus 1, and h of x equals square root of x. Let's start out with finding f of g of negative 2. Alright, so the first thing we need to do is write down what that means. That means f of g of negative 2. Okay, so I need to figure out what g of negative 2 is. Well, I can go over on the side, you don't have to do this, but I can figure out what g of negative 2 is by plugging in negative 2 into the function for g. Now remember, g of x was negative 4x plus 1, so g of negative 2 is negative 4 times negative 2 plus 1. So that gives you 8 plus 1 or 9. So when you plug in negative 2 for x into the function for g, we're going to get 9. So now we go back to finish this problem. So now that we know if g of negative 2 is 9, I really need to figure out what f of 9 equals. All right, so now let's look back up to the top here. F of x is x squared minus 3x plus 5, so we're going to plug in 9 for x. So that gives you 9 squared minus 3 times 9 plus 5. So we have 81 minus 27 plus 5. So you can go left to right. 81 minus 27 is 54. Add 5. And the answer is 59. So that's how we would do f of g of negative 2. Here's another example. Same three functions, but I'm asking for h of g of negative 2. See if you can do this on your own by putting the video on pause and then coming back to it. All right, so again, this means h of g of negative 2. So I need to figure out what g of negative 2 is. All right, so again, we're going to look at the g of x is negative 4x plus 1, so g of negative 2 means I'm plugging in negative 2 for x. Notice this is exactly what we did a second ago. I forgot the equal sign. So this is equal to 8 plus 1, or 9. All right, so from the previous problem, we also got that the g of negative 2 is 9. I'm just doing the same steps here. So then we want h of 9. Right, because g of negative 2 is 9, right? I'm plugging that in, 9 for g of negative 2. Now, we have to look at what's h of 9. So we have to go back up to the function for h, which is the square root of x. So h of 9 would be the square root of 9, and the square root of 9 is 3. And this is not number 1, this is number 2. So, for h of g of negative 2 is 3. Let's use these same three functions and compute g of f of 4. Again, try this on your own by putting the video on pause. All right, so remember this means g of f of 4. So we need to figure out f of 4. Now remember, since f of x is x squared minus 3x plus 5, then f of 4 would be 4 squared minus 3 times 4 plus 5. We're just plugging in 4 for x into the function for f. So 16 minus 12 plus 5 is, well, 16 minus 12 is 4, plus 5 more will give it 9. So I'm going to plug in 9 for f of 4. So we come back over here. You don't have to do this on the side. You could write all this within that parentheses, but it seems like it helps people to do the side work. It's up to you. So we have g of, now I know f of 4 is 9, Right, now I have to look at the function for g. All right, g of x is negative 4x plus 1, so I'm going to plug in 9 for x. So I have negative 4 times 9 plus 1. Negative 36 plus 1 is negative 35. All right, so hopefully you're getting the hang of it. Let's do some more. All right, here's the next one. Same three functions. How do you do h of f of negative 5? Go ahead and put the video on pause and try this on your own first. Okay, so what's this mean? It means h of f of negative 5. So I'm going to go over to the side again to figure out what f of negative 5 is. So remember, f of x equals x squared minus 3x plus 5. So we want f of negative 5. So we're going to have to put a negative 5 for x. Now, remember, we're doing x squared, so we have to do negative 5 times negative 5. So I'm going to write that. Negative 5 times negative 5, that's going to be x squared, minus 3 times negative 5 plus a 5. All right, so what's that give us? 25 plus 15 plus 5. Which is 45. So in place of f of negative 5 here, we're going to plug in 45. So we get h of 45. Now we look at the h function. H of x is square root of x. So we want the square root of 45. Is that simplified? Nope, because it has a factor of 9 in 45, which is a perfect square. So I think of this as the square root of 9 times 5, and I could take a 3 out because that's the square root of 9, so then my final answer is 3 square roots of 5. All right, what if we want to use the same three functions, and let's find f of g of x. Okay, so we're not plugging in a number each this time. So we have f of g of x, and now we know what g of x is. We just look up here, and g of x is negative 4x plus 1, so that's what we replace g of x with. So we're just going to have to still deal with the variables. And then we want f of negative 4x plus 1, so we have to go back up to the function f up here. And we're going to plug in negative 4x plus 1 everywhere there's an x. So we have negative 4x plus 1 squared minus 3 times negative 4x plus 1 plus 5. And then we have to be careful when you're scoring this binomial. You don't forget your middle term. That'll give you a 16x squared minus 8x plus 1. Remember, you could do that as negative 4x plus 1 times negative 4x plus 1. Do the FOIL method, get all four terms, and then you'll get that correct middle term of negative 8x. All right, we've got the distributive property here. Negative 3 times negative 4 is plus 12x, and the negative 3 times 1 is negative 1. I'm sorry, negative 3. And we have a plus 5 hanging out there. Almost done. All we have to do is add like terms. So we have 16x squared. Let's see, we've got a negative 8 plus 12. That's the x terms. So that's going to be plus 4x. And let's see, we have 1 minus 3 and a plus 5. That's plus 3. And that is your answer. Now here's something interesting. The first problem we did was f of g of negative 2, and we got 59. These were the steps we used. We just figured out f of g of x and got 16x squared plus 4x plus 3. So if you first figure out f of g of x, you could then just plug in the negative 2 into this one function. So just so you can see that that works, that will give you 16 times x squared, that's a negative 2 squared, plus 4 times a negative 2 plus 3. Now, the quantity negative 2 squared, negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. And then we have plus a negative 8, or minus 8, and plus 3. So that gives me 64 minus 8 plus 3, which is also 59. You should get the same answer if you wanted to first compute f of g of x. Now, that would be convenient if you were doing a whole bunch of problems like f of g of 3, f of g of 9, f of g of a bunch of things. But if it's just for negative 2, it wasn't so bad. You just do g of negative 2 and then plug that in and we'll get 59. But this is just something to pay attention to, that this also gives you the correct answer.